surgeon, because itself the complexity of the problem that not appreciated by the patient or nor by the understood sometimes by the surgeon. Second, these cases demand a wide range of sophisticated surgical technique. So really the crooked nose is a really challenge and frustrating job for a rhinoplasty surgeon. There is usually we use the two term, one is the deviated nose and another is the crooked nose. So the deviated nose, in the deviated nose, the dorsum, that is always straight but is shifted from the midline. But in the crooked nose, the septum, the dorsum is in the midline, but either C-sept or S-sept curved. So this is the basic difference between the deviated nose and the crooked nose. In deviated nose, this nose is straight, the dorsum is straight, but is shifted from the midline. So these are the different types of the deformity in the crooked nose. So there is basic five types of the deviations. Like in the first, the patient have the bony pyramid and the cartilages both tilted. But in the type second, third and fourth, the bony pyramid is straight, but the cartilaginous pyramid is the different type of the deformities. And in the type fifth, the bony pyramid and the cartilaginous vault both straight tilted in the same direction. So these are the different type of the deformities. Now it's very important thing to understand the etiology and the pathology of the nasal deviations for a rhinoplasty surgeons. Sometimes the patient have a congenital abnormality that have the crooked nose, or sometimes the patient is the post-traumatic, sometimes due to the previous surgery or either due to the only septal problems. If you identify the etiology of the deformity, then it's better to explain. Suppose if your patient is the post-traumatic, then in that case it's very difficult to identify the septum or for the reconstruction purpose septum. So it's better to explain your patient for harvesting graft. Or like if your patient have due to the previous surgery, then you identify which type of the graft you are earlier surgeon you use. So the history part is also important. So you try to identify the etiology of the deviations. Now the goal of the surgery just to create a rigid and the straight cartilaginous L strut, and then correction of the deviated bony structure and improvement of the nasal airways. So how we correct a crooked nose? The most important thing, the accurate preoperative analysis. By the analysis, you just identify what underlying deformity under the skin. Another, understanding etiology and nasal anatomy of the deviated nose. And the third is the intraoperative diagnosis. Once you expose your skin flap, then you again check what deformity presumed earlier. Then alter and the control the bony pyramid and septum. So these are the main steps. Now for preoperative aesthetic analysis of the nose, for any like case, we have these basic views like frontal view, profile view, basal view and the skyline view. But the important thing, we all assess systematically. Like in the frontal view, we assess about the degree of the deviations, about the dorsal asymmetries, about the asymmetries, the upper lateral and the lower lateral, and the broad tip aesthetic lines and the caudal septum deviations. So you assess like systematically, like the upper third, like the mid third. And in the profile view, you assess about the details of the radix, about the dorsal irregularities, either your patient have hump or the depression on the dorsum, about the nasofrontal angle detail, nasolabial angle detail, and about the projection and the rotations. So these things you assess in the profile view. In the basal view, you assess basically about the size, shape and the orientation of the nostrils and width of the nasal base. Another important views for the crooked nose, that is the skyline view, because sometimes the deviation does not appear in the frontal view. So this is the best view for appearance of the deviations. and the details of the broty aesthetic line. Now, the surgical step for the nasal deviation treatment is the three step for the deviation corrections. The first, that is the for like any surgery, that is the complete exposure, and then wide exposure of the all deviated structure, wide release of all mucopericondial attachment, then complete septal reconstruction and the bony pyramid correction by the different type of the osteotomies. So these are the basic steps for correction of a deviated notch. We use the open approach frequently for the corrections. Although Dr. Ali yesterday very wonderful demonstrations by the closed approach, but for the beginners, for the complete exposure, open approach is preferred because it allows the direct visualization of the anatomic structures and offer unlimited access to the septum and bony structure and the tip cartilage. So for that we use the different type of the incisions. We yesterday already discussed that the type of the incisions doesn't matter, either you use the inverted V, W or stair step. For my junior colleague, the important thing is the site of the incision. Your site of the incision should be the mid of the columella, because the mid part of the columella skin have the more approximated with the margin of the medial crust. So you less chance of the scar there. So, and we use a broken line incision either the different in zigzag fashions, so the less chance of the visibility of the scar. Now for the open exposure, we already seen so many cases. For the marginal incision, you always your incision along the margin of the lateral crust, so you can palpate the margin of the lateral crust with the either handle of knife or a cap of syringe, because the site of the incision like transcolumnar incision or like the marginal incision is both important. The site of incision is important thing. For the transcolumellar incision, we use this inverted V incision that have the two part, one is the vertical and the horizontal. So when we pass a seizure from one side to another side, if you feel the little bit resistance, then you change the direction of your seizure, otherwise you create a false passage. And once you finish this incision, after raising the columella flap, the first step just to identify the margin of the medial crust, and it's a beautiful technique. You use your seizure just like a pen holding positions. And look that my finger is just give the counter pressure for the better hemostasis. And you use at the dome area, this angle seizure is a very good seizure. So the lateral limit of the discus exposure that on the tip is around the 2/3 of the lateral crust, that should be adequate. And that we already discussed that plane of dissection, that is supra-pericondial, and we cut the ligament of the patangui earlier. And when we go for the mid-wall dissections, then first we identify the anterior septal angle area. So your exposure part is adequate, otherwise it's very difficult to do the surgery in a tunnel, and we have a lot of chance of the complications. So for the septal reconstructions, for the septal reconstruction, first for the straightening of the deviated septum, the straightening involves the rejections of the deviated portion of the septum. First with degloving of the septum. So because until unless you not remove the deviated septum, the deviated part of the septum that gives the external force of the septum. So when you excise the deviated part, then it eliminates the excess force on the normal septum there, and that it permits to allow septum in the midline. So after the complete degloving, and we create a dorsal caudal and L strut. So the second part for correction of the caudal septum, we use a 40 PDS suture. Some people use a burr hole in the anterior spine, but you can fix for the beginners it's easy by 40 PDS suture through the periosteum, and you check the mobility of the caudal septum. and you separate the upper lateral and the septum, and if for correction of a dorsal septum, if there is a excess convexity, then you excise that. So when we separate the upper lateral and the septum, then this excess force again eliminate, and they allow the septum in the midline. The important thing in the last part, that the restoration of the septal support again by use of the spreader graft. There is a little bit problem. So the spreader graft, basically spreader graft we place between the dorsal septum and the upper lateral cartilage in this sub mucopericondial pocket, and the length of the spreader graft, that ideally is the depend on the situation, but usually is a 20 to 30 millimeter long, and width is the 3 millimeter. And the important thing, whenever you have the indication of the spreader graft, then you use the spreader graft for the correction of the dorsal septal deviations or the inverted V deformity, or if the patient have the internal nasal wall insufficiency or reconstruction of the open roof deformity, when we reduction the dorsum more than 5 millimeter, and sometimes in the asymmetrical dorsal aesthetic line. So it's not necessary that in every case we use the spreader graft whenever we separate the upper lateral and the septum. So first we make an ideal dimension for the both sides, and it depend on the situation, either use the unilateral or the bilateral. So after the, then we put it between the mucoporicondial pocket, and you fix either the 3 structure first or the 5 structure simultaneously. It depend on the surgeon preference. For the beginners, I think you fix the 3 structure first, the septum on both sides and the spreader, and then all 5 structures simultaneous. And say inverted mattress suture. If you have a straight needle, that's good, but bad luck in India, we don't have the straight needle. So 2 or 3 suture is enough. So it's not necessary then, whenever we open the upper lateral and septum, in every case you use the spreader graft, because the like the all standard book like Rollin Daniel and Dean Torumi, they all mention, then whenever you separate the spreader and the whenever you separate the upper lateral and septum, they use as a rule the spreader graft, because the Western literature they have a thin skin patient, but in India we already have the very thick skins and we have very good mid vault support, so there is no need to use in every case the spreader graft. Now for the bony wall corrections, we use different type of the osteotomies. For the crooked nose, we use the lateral osteotomy, medial osteotomy, and the intermediate osteotomy, and the cross root osteotomy. We use this different type of the osteotomy. So other than the crooked nose, we use the osteotomy, either we use the medial osteotomy first and the lateral osteotomy, doesn't matter. But in crooked nose, osteotomy should be used in the sequential manner. We already discussed that first we use, if we use the intermediate osteotomy, then in intermediate osteotomy we always use first to the lateral osteotomy before prior to the lateral osteotomy, because if you first do the lateral osteotomy, then the part of that bone is destabilized, then it's very difficult to do that. So whenever you do the double osteotomy, then first do prior to the lateral osteotomy. And in asymmetrical nose, like if one side nasal bone is longer than other, in that case the concave side you address first rather than convex side, because if you correct the convex side, then it's very difficult to change the concave side. So if you first correct the concave side, then it gives permit to the convex side in the midline. So the sequence is important for crooked nose corrections, and it's a good habit to always mark and the marking should be, I think, before to the infiltration, because sometimes after the infiltrations they camouflage the irregularities of the nose. So for the intermediate osteotomy between the top and the junction, between the top and the bottom, we use this 2 mm medicone osteotome. And the infiltration part is important. We infiltrate and then wait for proper hemostasis and hydro dissection. We use this guarded osteotome. There's the two different osteotome, right and left, and you use the two tap technique. So and when we sometimes the then upper lateral and the septum is not separate, and in that case you can use direct in this way the osteotomy through the inside of the nose, medial osteotomy. But the medial osteotomy, that should be in the 20 degree in offline positions, in median oblique fashions, and always you palpate by your other hand finger the where you are working. So the sequence and the side, which side you, that is more important thing for a crooked nose. So this is the case. We have a open approach and the spreaders and the high lateral osteotomies. We have another case that the open approach and the intermediate osteotomies, and this is a case of the traumatic that we use the open approach and different type of the osteotomies. So finally, the take home message that the clinical analysis of the cause and anatomy of the nasal deviation is essential in planning corrective surgery of a deviated nose, and the all deviated structure should be widely released to allow replacement in the correct anatomic positions, and the finally anatomical reconstruction of a deviated septum and bony structure is mandatory to achieve a predictable aesthetic and the functional result in a deviated nose. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sunil.